This matter raises an important question of public law arising from the interpretation and application of Section 75 sub 7, read with Section 79 of the Correctional Services Act 111 of 1998 and the regulations promulgated thereunder. In my view, this matter merits the Supreme Court of Appeal's attention to bring certainty in the correct interpretation and application of these provisions. I'm also of the view that there is a reasonable possibility that another court may find that the order that the third respondent's time spent on medical parole should not count towards fulfilling his sentence, as this impacts on him unfairly in that, one, it was not his decision, but that of the commissioner to be released on medical parole. Second, his meeting with his political allies and a prayer meeting was a once-off thing. His freedom of movement is restricted, and this has an impact on his dignity. He is serving his sentence, albeit outside prison. Third, because his illness and advanced age, what I want to say is because of his illness and advanced age, he needs compassion, he needs empathy and humaneness, which is the essence of Ubuntu. In my view, another court may take this into consideration and come to a different finding. Accordingly, for the above reason, leave to appeal is granted to the Supreme Court of Appeal, and that cost will be cost in the appeal. Court adjourns. You are all excused.
As the court,
thanks.